Welcome to the special edition of Agenda, which we're calling Two States. Over the next 30 minutes, a day before Haryana and Maharashtra go to polls, we give you a taste of the issues involved. We have some young voters from Haryana and of course two very special guests. Here we have Ravinder Singh. He is a young author of very popular books like I Too Had a Love Story. His next book is actually set in Haryana politics. And we have Latika Tukral, a founder member of a very popular people's movement here in Gurgaon called Ragari and also of I Am Gurgaon. So we'll be talking to them in just a bit. And there in Maharashtra, Tejas will take you through it.
Thanks, Netra. I'm Tejas Mehta and come to you from Mumbai. Here, of course, the scale is absolutely at an altogether different level given the fact this is the second biggest state in Maharashtra. Over 4,000 candidates in the fray, five different big political parties seeking the vote from Mumbaikars and Maharashtrians. But of course, this is all for 288 seats. It doesn't get bigger than this, but let's first go straight to my colleague Bachi Karkaria, who joins us also, expert, who is going to tell us exactly what's going to happen, and a slew of voters here, young voters, who will decide the fate of all these 288 different seats across Maharashtra. But first, a look at what the Association of Democratic Reforms has got to say. Let's break away straight away for you these two very important states.
Get a common ground between two states as diverse as Maharashtra and Haryana, but our first talking point is perhaps a common ground. We don't see a big alliance this time round. So our first question that we want to get out is, no alliances, what does it mean for the voters? Ravinder, what does it mean for you?
Well, to me it means that you don't need to make permutation combination. You straight away go out, you don't find that, okay, if I vote for X party, X and Y will come tomorrow, so ultimately that person will again win out there.
Yes.
It's a common ground. You like A, go and vote for A. You like B, go and vote for B.
And for you, Latika, as someone who's been fighting for better amenities, do you get a clearer picture of what is in store if you vote for who from the manifestos?
Not at all. I have no clue who's going to win, and we are all confused in terms of which party will come in. It's really, really confusing this time.
Confusing. Tejas, is it confusing for the people in Mumbai as well? Because we've seen such major alliance breakups, dramatic ones in Maharashtra.
Well, that's right, Sunetra. A big, big day tomorrow, and here in Mumbai and Maharashtra. Let's straight away go to Bachi Karkaria. Bachi, what are the big issues Mumbai and Maharashtra vote on tomorrow, given the fact that the political scenario has completely changed in the last 2 to 3 weeks?
You know, this is a really different kind of election from any that I've seen in Maharashtra, in that who people vote for is going to be as important as what they vote for. Because this time there is these conflicting or sometimes coalescing threads of there's regional pride, there's what we stand for as Maharashtrians, what we stand for as Mumbaikars, who's going to reinforce this pride in this state and us in this city. Because all along we have seen steady chaos, steady deterioration, and we really don't know why Maharashtra has lost the kind of the plot and lost the position that it always had. Mumbai, which used to be Urbs Prima in Indus, is becoming one of the worst kind of cities, imploding on itself. So people really want to know what the hell is going to come out of this election, and I'm sure they're going to come out in large numbers tomorrow.
Let's just go to our young crowd here, because these are the very, very crucial voters going to be tomorrow. Tell me, as far as you are concerned, what is the big issue that you want as far as, say, Mumbai is concerned? What is the big issue for you?
Coming out of after the Lok Sabha elections and what we have right now in front of us, the biggest issue right now in Bombay and that Bombay is struggling with is infrastructure at a very large scale, I must say. Infrastructure in all terms, everywhere in Bombay is needed in terms of traffic and the state of buildings, heritage buildings and all of that. And I think what the new government that will come into place after these elections is, this is one main key point to which they need to focus
infrastructure,
on.
As far as Mumbai is concerned, Bachi, infrastructure being one of the main issues, Sunetra, I think that's one big issue with all our metros, because the chaos we see every day, absolutely, you know, unmanageable for the Aam Aadmi, really. Sunetra.
That's interesting, because I was just going to ask all these young voters over there, when you heard people, Tejas, speaking of young people there and talking about infrastructure, are these things that we can all identify over here in Haryana as well? You're from Rohtak. Can you identify with that?
Yeah, it is very much similar in Rohtak, because there also we find that infrastructure and development overall in the city is very
important. And madam,
you're
from the Chief Minister's constituency.
Yeah, of course.
And you have infrastructure as a problem.
It used to be a problem, but now things have improved a lot. So that has changed the scenario in Rohtak city as such.
So it's interesting. Do you think people, and are you going to vote for a change? Are you going to go with what's been going?
I'm going to go with what's there, because I have seen the change in 10 years in Rohtak.
Okay. You know, when you heard Bombayites speaking over there, Tejas's guest, did you feel that there is a kind of common ground that there is in aspirations of people?
You know, I think all cities are facing similar problems, and looking at that, infrastructure becomes a very, very important part of it. But in Gurgaon specifically, because it's a new city, it's a work in progress in many ways. We have issues of local governance. We have issues of local body. We do not have an empowered municipal corporation.
And
so that is causing issues, and we don't have a single authority. We have various authorities in Gurgaon.
And I think that's what Bombay also would have in common, and I'll throw back to Tejas. But before that, just Ravinder, everyone over here, we are sitting in Gurgaon, which like Mumbai is a pampered place. Mumbai, of course, at a much larger level. How is Haryana different from Gurgaon?
Well, not many aspects. In fact, Gurgaon is a millennium city at the same time. It's a gaon at the same time. We have, you know, carved a whole city out of a gaon.
Mm-hmm.
So I think there are different set of challenges out here. I mean, we are born and brought up in a country wherein we are not surprised to see cattle on the road. But come Gurgaon, there are a couple of corporate sectors where, forget cattle, the pigs and the donkeys are the prime challenge. I drop my wife out there and I say, where exactly are we? Just next to the Huda metro station behind Fortis Hospital. It's amazing. There are so many road accidents taking place just because of the pigs out there.
Yeah, and you know, these are the kind of infrastructure issues that we all talk about. But if we bring it back to the politics where people are voting tomorrow, Tejas, the really big talking point where we'd like to know what your experts have to say is, there is no CM candidate perhaps clearly there. Of course, for the Congress it is, but BJP, totally different. Is that changing the voting pattern for people?
Well, certainly it's become Modi 11 versus the rest of Maharashtra. Isn't that true? You know, as far as Maharashtra is concerned, the focus has been fully on Modi, and also there is no chief minister candidate for the BJP. So how does the common man vote when it comes to the BJP?
This is really very strange, because this time, you know, it's a slightly different hawa from what there was during the May elections, because there was this very clear sweep. It became apparent to even the unbelievers that yes, this election was going over to BJP unless something very big happened on election day. But the point here is that this time BJP says, we are the only people, vote for us because we are at the center and we will sweep you along on our tide. But that's not what's happening here, because here, you know, the Shiv Sena, in fact the two Senas, one more than the other, has made a very, very strong pitch for regionalism, for the pride of Maharashtra, and the pride of Maharashtra, not just of the Marathi Manus. And I think here Modi has tried to take away that aura by very surprisingly calling upon the Ashirvad of Shivaji, who is by any token the icon of the Senas. But I don't know how far this ploy is going to work.
Let me ask our young voters, tell me, the fact that there is no chief ministerial candidate for the BJP, does it work for them? Because everybody else you have got Uddhav Thackeray, Raj Thackeray, Ajit Pawar and Prithviraj Chauhan, but nobody in BJP. Are you going to vote for Narendra Modi or you are seeing a faceless CM?
Actually, to be said, there is a faceless CM till where BJP is concerned, because as I said, he's the one who is going to work in the center. If we go to vote in the name of Narendra Modi, he is not the one who is going to be the face here in Maharashtra. So for right now here, the wave of Modi worked in the Lok Sabha, but I don't think it would be.
That's a big question, as even the Shiv Sena is putting, will the Modi wave really work in this election? But of course, Sunetra, another big issue, there are no alliances this time here in Maharashtra. So completely new ball game as far as Maharashtra is concerned.
Okay, and I just wanted to, about the CM candidate. I was speaking to a young student over here. What did you want to say about that CM candidate? How is it different here in Haryana? How are people doing it?
BJP does not have a CM candidate right now. If we talk about VK Singh, he has his own disputes, and I feel he has served Indian Army for a long time. He has not out in civil, so he does not know the.
What about Abhimanyu, Captain Abhimanyu?
I don't feel he's also like that.
Does that change anyone else's voting? You are a fan of Bishnois, right? Why is that? आपको क्यों पसंद आते हैं वो लोग?
क्योंकि मैं वो अपना पार्टी के लिए और अपने युवा यूथ के लिए काम करना चाहते हैं. और क्योंकि अगर बीजेपी को देखो तो बीजेपी में कोई भी ऐसे नहीं है, क्योंकि रामविलास खुद देख लो, उन्होंने टिकट बंटवारे में भी घपला किया था.
okay.
और उन्होंने गठबंधन तोड़ा.
okay.
वो इसलिए क्योंकि उनको लगा कि अगर हम मुख्यमंत्री नहीं बनेंगे
yeah.
तो ये अदर पार्टी के बनेंगे.
okay.
तो इसलिए.
So is there a big leadership emerging out of Haryana? I just want to know, because Maharashtra's, we heard Bachchi Karkaria talk just now, they had very clear, well-defined major leaders. Do we have that apart from what we've seen, the Hoodas come up, how they ruled in the last 10 years, but any other new leadership?
I would have loved to see a face coming out of, evolving out of BJP as such. But the whole campaign has been Modi ke saath chalo.
Right.
And that's where. And people are smart today. They know the difference between a Lok Sabha election versus an assembly.
Okay.
Look at what happened with Aam Aadmi Party in Delhi election versus with them at the national level.
Okay.
So the challenges still remain the same. You don't have a prominent face from BJP.
Okay. And for you, do you think the whole thing about Modi ke saath chalo, the development thing, do you think that's working? Is that the vote for that in Haryana?
I don't think so. I think it is to do with the local people around here or the local candidates. So I don't see that wave of Modi in at least in Gurgaon.
Okay, we're going to take a short break now on Two States special edition of Agenda. When we come back, Tejas and I are going to get you the answers from our audience to that special question. What does youngest Tan want? Coming up in just a bit, a day before elections.